welcome if you're new. So today I'm gonna be showing you how I got this misty pink color with a blonde wig from Victoria's Wigs. So if you wanna see how I got this look, keep watching. So this wig is from Victoria's Wigs. It comes in this really cute box and they also have a bag inside. Don't mind the box, that thing got destroyed in my closet. Inside you always get all kind of goodies like a wig cap, a comb, some tweezers, an edge control brush, everything. So this is a 613 13 by 6 inch lace front wig and I got it in 12 inches. Be sure to use my code SL15 to save 25% off of your order. Cap construction is amazing as always. You have a comb on both sides and a comb in the back, a comb in the middle, adjustable straps, and a removable elastic band. Not to mention this has lace in the back and a ridiculous amount of parting space. This was actually a really great shade of blonde. It was a lot more ice blonde than it was that yellowy bleach blonde. I wish I had something to compare it to because it's hard to show up on camera, but this is a good color and the hair is very soft. So I decided to use some of these Japanese hair dye brands. I was going for like an ashy pink and I usually use this one here. I really, really like this one. Tried to just use one box, but later on I discovered that I definitely needed two. Very, very easy to use. You just mix these two things together, shake it up and then apply it to the hair. It's actually really, really easy and simple. Instead of dyeing it on my head, I decided to dye it on the mannequin head and I put a plastic bag over it just so I don't like get it all messed up. And then the dyeing process is just super easy. I just went through it with that comb and tried to put the dye all over the hair as quickly as possible. I definitely would recommend starting at the ends of the hair and working the way up, but I started at the root of the hair and worked my way down. The only reason why I suggest going the other way is because the dye will be darker wherever it's left on for longer, if that makes any sense. So if you want that ombre effect and you want the ends to be darker, definitely start at the ends of the hair and then work your way up to the roots. Don't forget to like section the hair and like make sure that you're spreading the dye like all over the place. You don't want any patches or to like miss any spots. I soon discovered I needed two boxes, so I'm actually mixing these two brands together. I've never used this box before, but it was really pretty. Looked very similar to the first one. It was kind of like an ashy, dusty pink. Really worried at first because everything was looking purple, and I thought it was gonna be too dark, but after I washed it out, it actually was pink. I'm going in with that second bottle, and I'm just applying it all over the hair again. As you can see, there are so many spots that I missed because it just was not enough dye. So I just went in and applied the dye all over everything, making sure not to miss any spots, and I let it sit for like, I wanna say 3 to 5 minutes. Before I washed it out. After that, I put the hair back on the mannequin head, brushed it out, and I let this air dry overnight. I made sure to part the hair in the style that I wanted it so that it would dry properly and that it wasn't so difficult to style afterwards. After it air dried, the next day I went in with some argan oil just to give it a little bit more life. I then began sectioning the hair so that I could flat iron it. The only problem was while flat ironing it, I realized the back wasn't really that dry. It was still kind of wet, but I still managed to get it to be quite straight. I'm very, very happy with this color. It's super cute, kind of just what I was going for. Something different, just like a dusty, I want to say like ashy pink color. After that, I put it on my head and I cut off the lace very, very poorly, may I say. And since this is a blonde unit, the lace is like that white transparent color, which does not match with my skin. So I went in with some foundation and I went over the lace, but I was so dumb and used powder instead of liquid and it kind of like seeped through the lace. After that, I cut some baby hairs and just sleeked them down with some gel. I use Eco Styling Gel for pretty much all my baby hairs. And this little cute brush actually comes with your wig, which is very helpful because I always use these for sleeking down my edges. I wrapped it and then I began curling the ends inward just to give it a little bit of oomph. And that was it. It was super duper easy to style. The hair is very soft and beautiful and I love, love this color. Let me know what you guys think. I've already been rocking it all week. You're seeing this like a little bit late, but your girl been out in the town in a pink wig. I just love wearing colored hair in summer. So far, loving this one. It took the dye really easily, it washed really easily, dried, curled, all that. The hair is really soft and the cap construction was amazing. The really, really, really good part about this wig was the hair was not that yellowy, bleachy color. If you saw when I took it out, like, this was a white blonde color. I was so surprised, which is kind of like the blonde that everyone wants, but we get that bleach yellow one. So for those of you guys looking for that, like, ice blonde color, like, this is it. Like, while I was dyeing it and, like, combing through it with the dye, it was not shedding a whole bunch like blonde units usually do. I have a lot of issues with blonde units. They just usually ain't. They ain't that great. So that's it, you guys. If you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment down below. I will get back to you. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe so I can make more videos. And yeah, I will see you guys next time.